What are the 10 most important items in the home pantry? I'm going to tell you the 10 items that I cannot live without in my kitchen cabinets. And a couple of them are going to be maybe a little different from what you would expect, but hey, we all like different things, right? Okay, now the first one here is no surprise. This is fast rise yeast. I like to use fast rise because I'm a little lazy and impatient. So I swapped traditional yeast for the fast rise yeast a few years back, and I really especially love it because I am originally from Philadelphia, where they have soft pretzels and sold in the street everywhere, very affordable. When I was younger, they were like $4 for $1. And where I live, I can't find them. And there are frozen pretzels that you can find. I forget who manufactures them, but they're really just not the same. So between homemade breads and pretzels and not being able to get to the store for fresh bread sometimes, you know, I like to use yeast for that purpose. Let's move on to the next item, and that is evaporated milk. Now, we got the fat-free kind by mistake, and we just haven't used it yet. So I generally get the full-fat evaporated milk. I don't really keep condensed milk, the kind that has the sugar added too much. We get a few of those a year, but evaporated milk is really highly important, especially if you run out of fresh milk. And I haven't bought powdered milk in a long time. It seems to be a big investment, and it really doesn't seem to be any cheaper than whole milk. And maybe I should buy a box of it, but really canned milk has been a mainstay for me, especially for pumpkin pie and stuff like that. And we are going to move to the next item here, which is canned fish. All right, so if I had to choose one of these only, it would be the tuna, even though like the salmon is better for you. It's just because tuna is really so versatile. So but in general, I would say canned fish of some kind. All right, but tuna is cheaper, and certainly it is something I put in casseroles, in sandwiches, in pasta, in salad, and I cannot live without it. And when I'm lucky enough, I can get these two for a dollar on a sale a couple times a year. But who knows if that's ever going to happen again, right? All right, here is another one, quick oats. I like quick oats. I stopped using the larger whole oat a little while ago because I find that this works well in any recipe. I use it in meatloaf. I eat it a lot, especially in the winter time. And I wish I could find these at the dollar store, like in $1 canisters for some videos, but I find it very hard to ever find oats that aren't like around $1.70. So that's why another reason I don't use those in my challenges a lot. But now if it weren't oats, it would be oat bran. I really, really love oat bran cereal. It's kind of like cream of wheat. So, but this is harder to find. Oat bran is much harder to find in the stores. A lot of places don't even carry it. So for that purpose, quick oats is highly, highly useful. Cereal, meatloaf, cookies, everything. All right, the next item here is sunflower kernels, all right? I'll show you some alternatives to this as well. Sunflower kernels, I swear, are one of the most nutritious foods on earth. And I will put them in morning cereal, whether it's hot or cold. And I would say, when I was buying this a couple years ago, it was only $1.99 a pound, but it has to be from a store that sells them without salt, which is hard to find. So the last time I bought these, now I bought this online, but the last time I bought sunflower kernels without salt, it was out of town. All right, nobody where I live sells them. So it's really just, you know, lucky. If you live around a bulk store, highly useful to get these. All right, now, if it's not for sunflower kernels, peanuts are another great option for that because, yes, I have put peanuts in cereal. I've put it in oatmeal. It's just whatever works, whatever gives you that protein and fat and calories for the day. But I really generally like these for snacking. Sometimes I'll put them in cookies. I'll put them in stir fries. You guys have seen some of my videos where I incorporate peanuts into very low budget meals. And I do like to get the ones without salt, but for snacking, I like to get ones that are lightly salted or just have the regular traditional salt. And if it's for like a more expensive seed or nut, I would go with almonds because these are actually probably the next cheapest nut next to sunflower seeds and peanuts is almonds. I think these are probably $6.99 a pound for now anyway. Okay, so the next category here is beans. Some kind of bean. I find pinto beans to be the cheapest, and it's tasty, but it does tend to be the cheapest. If I go to Walmart, I can get them in 8-pound bags. A lot of nuts, I have complained in my some of my recent videos, they're hard to find anymore at 99 cents or a dollar a pound. Sometimes I am a little lucky, but if I get it in this bulk 8-pound bag, it is a dollar a pound or less. Okay, and I can't find anything else as cheap as pinto beans usually. All right, the next category is some kind of fruit with vitamin C. So I'll show you, for example, this is an item I think I only showed once in one of my other videos. This is mulberries, dried mulberries. I'll show you why I use them. Here is what they look like right here. And the reason why I get these is because it's a pantry stable. Sorry for that noise. It's a pantry stable food that you can use to get vitamin C from that is not really too expensive. Now, they're not very easy to find. Generally, you have to get them online. I think probably Whole Foods might carry them sometimes, or some really good bulk food stores will have these. And these are very highly concentrated in vitamin C. I think 2 tablespoons of it contains about 40 or 50% of your vitamin C for the day, and a quarter of a cup, it's either 2 tablespoons or a quarter of a cup contains 50% of your vitamin C, but I think it's 2 tablespoons. So the reason why I like that, why I like these so much, is because there aren't a lot of shelf-stable dried fruits that are affordable that provide vitamin C. Like, let's say you live in an area where you can't get to the store that much. Like, let's say you live in like upstate New York, in the middle of winter, there's snow, or you live in North Dakota or something like that, and it's just always snowy, really, really cold. This is something good to have, because the other option here is something that provides vitamin C, like canned fruit, like canned pineapple. So for example here, this can has 4.5 servings, and there is 20% of vitamin C per serving, right? So I like to have something in the pantry that is fruit that has vitamin C. Now, if you don't have any of those, there's always the cheap vitamin C tablets, but you know, I think getting it from food is ideal. I want to tell you something that made me laugh. My husband calls these little things dust bunnies because they're really not all that moist. It depends on how fresh they are when you get them. This batch was like so-so, and they're kind of mild tasting, but my husband, like, he calls them dust bunnies. They look like dust bunnies, but trust me, they do taste good. Okay. Now, the next item that I have to have in my pantry, no surprise, is flour. It's generally whole wheat flour, but we keep both on hand because some recipes don't do quite as well without all-purpose flour, or just some recipes that you find, they just call for it, or you feel like eating that pillowy, soft, white bread. Okay, especially like when I make my soft pretzels. So so flour is always an option. So I didn't mention, I'm not done yet, but I didn't mention salt or pepper or oil, because those are like really extremely basic. So I could have done that, but I chose these 10. All right, so I'm on the ninth one right now. Diced tomatoes. They are just so versatile. And they also do have vitamin C, even though they are have been canned. They 15% of vitamin C per serving, per half cup serving. Also has some vitamin A in there. And this is great for like goulash, chili, soup. You know, the list goes on and on. You can put it in your morning scrambled eggs if you don't have any fresh tomatoes. These are just indispensable. And now the final item, guys, is rice. Okay, rice is really just, I can't say enough about it. If you run out of oats, if you run out of all other kinds of cereal, you can make hot rice cereal in the morning, which I have done. All right, but rice is generally like a big staple in our house. I do have a huge bag of jasmine rice right now, but I still have a couple of these. So anyway, those are my 10 items, and I showed you some alternatives just to give you some ideas for like if you wanted to stock up on something like the vitamin C fruits or something like that, just some various ideas. So I've been jibber jabbering here the whole time, but I would like to know what are your 10 pantry staples that you cannot live without. I know that I did leave some really important items out from here, but I wanted to limit it to 10. Okay, so I really would like to know in the comments, guys. I think this is a great topic. For those of you who can't afford enough, you know, you don't have the money for pantry items, just say if you did have the money, what you would stock up in. Okay? All right. See you in the comments. I'm really excited to see your input. Talk to you later, guys.